The Philippines' COVID-19 tally up by more than 4,600 in the past week. The country averaged 662 new daily cases from June 20th to the 26th. Officials say this was 53% higher from the week before that. Some 591 patients are in severe to critical conditions. The health department also reporting 51 deaths from that period. The hospital bed utilization rate was at 18.1%. The ICU utilization rate was at 14.9%.
San Juan City's mayor says the COVID situation there is under control, despite a noted rise in infections. Mayor Francis Zamora says the city so far has 37 active COVID cases. All cases are mild or asymptomatic, and no one has been hospitalized. That's why he believes an escalation of the COVID alert level is not in order.
I would rather stay at level one at this point. It's not the time to panic. Yes, the numbers are increasing, but let us not panic because we have our vaccination. We simply have to continue following all health and safety protocols. Right now, the ICU utilization and hospital utilization are very low. We have enough quarantine facilities, and I believe each and every LGU has learned the experience from the past 2.5 years. This is not new to us. We have battled this in the past 2.5 years, and I'm sure each and every LGU is ready just in case there will be a surge.
The private sector stands by its remark the Philippine economy cannot afford to go back to a higher COVID alert level despite the rising infections. Presidential Advisor for Entrepreneurship Joey Concepcion cites the low hospitalization rate in the country. But he's retracting his suggestion to make the wearing of face masks outdoors optional.
Unang-una ang position ko sa face mask kasi outdoor, nagbayaran na lahat, wala nang problema. Let's just encourage the use katulad ng ibang bansa. Pero after listening to all of them, I thought it was a wise decision to hold that off muna. Allow muna natin itong surge to taper off and eventually look into that later on when we reach that point.
More news, re-elected Senator Rizzo Ontiveros officially becomes the next leader of the opposition. Ontiveros took her oath before outgoing Vice President Lenny Robredo on Monday. She was accompanied by her three daughters. Ontiveros said she would continue her advocacies at the Senate, including efforts on COVID-19 response and other health initiatives. She also vowed to continue the fight against false information.
We'll fight back harder against rumors, lies, propaganda, and fake news. Let me make this even clearer. This is a stern warning to all the dubious characters in the fake news universe. This time, we will not let your reckless disregard for truth slander our democracy, our country, ever again.
Robredo, meanwhile, said she would stand by the lawmaker and would extend help whenever she needs it.
Senator-elect Rafi Tulfo in favor of reviving the Senate's probe into the government's pandemic supply deals with Pharmaly. Tulfo says there are still unaddressed concerns about the matter. He adds he's willing to be part of the Senate Blue Ribbon Committee, which led the probe into the controversy. Tulfo also stresses he's not afraid to engage in a debate with any senator.
Nirespeto ko naman sila, and I hope they will also respect me. I respect their opinion, and I hope they'll do the same. Wala ka dapat katakutan, kasi once na nadala ka sa takot, then hindi ka na makapagtrabaho, hindi ka na makapag-perform, nandun na yung fear. Ayaw mo lang pumunta sa work dahil kinakatakutan mo yung that certain person. That should not be.
The Senate failed to adopt the Blue Ribbon Committee's report before the 18th Congress adjourned earlier this month. That report recommended charges against some government officials, including President Duterte, and executives of Pharmaly for the allegedly anomalous pandemic deals.
Senator Ronald De La Rosa will refile a bill to make ROTC, or the Reserve Officers Training Corps, mandatory. De La Rosa argues the youth should have basic military training to help defend the country amid threats from China in the West Philippine Sea.
So, sabi ko nga sa kabataan ngayon, alam nyo, patriotism, yung pagdidepensa sa ating bansa, ay hindi mo yung makukuha being a keyboard warrior. You have to be a true warrior in order to defend this country from foreign aggression.
De La Rosa also notes he is aware of issues that hounded ROTC in the past. He says these will be addressed in the bill that he will file in the upcoming 19th Congress. ROTC, which was a mandatory military training in college, was made optional in 2002 following an alleged killing of a student by Corps officers. For a teacher's group, there are other ways to teach patriotism and discipline other than military training.
Bago pa natin pag-usapan itong mandatory military training, no, bakit hindi natin na pagtuunan ng pansin yung pagtuturo po ng basic human rights, no, ng rule of law, discipline po yan ang pinag-uusapan dyan, ano po, Philippine history, no, yung ating pong kultura, yung ating values, ano po, discipline po pinag-uusapan dyan, civic duties, ano.
Philippine authorities seeking ways to accelerate the process of deployment of overseas Filipino workers. The chief of the Philippine Overseas Employment Administration says this is one of the marching orders of incoming Migrant Workers Secretary Susan Ople. The POEA will be under the relatively new Migrant Workers Department once the agency is fully constituted.
Tinitignan po natin dito yung efficiency of the delivery of services to our OFWs ay napaka-importante. Kaya yung po ease of doing business, yan po ang kasalukuyang pinagtutuunan natin ng pansin. Kung paano mapapadali ang mga proseso, lalong-lalo na sa pag-aaproba ng mga prosesong mga dokumento.
Attorney Bernard Olalia also notes OFW deployments are slowly recovering, especially in the seafaring industry. Deployments fell by up to 74% in 2020 due to the COVID pandemic.